Sergio Martinez in the ring against Floyd Mayweather. Will we ever see that? If we do, what do you think about it? Because Sergio went on the record to go after Floyd.
Okay, and what weight does he want to fight him at?
150?
Well, I mean, because we all know that Martinez, he doesn't bring any money into the fight, you know, so.
After this weekend he does. I mean, last week or 2 weeks ago.
Well, what was his payday? A million? He got a million, right? So maybe he can ask for 2.5. Is he really going to get any more than that? I mean, him fighting Mayweather benefits Martinez than Mayweather.
Who do you want to see Mayweather fight then?
Canelo. That's the biggest fight outside of Pacquiao that can be made.
Why?
Because of the money. You got the Mexican following. Something like Cinco de Mayo. If Canelo has another fight in December and looks real good, Cinco de Mayo or May 6th or whatever it falls on, Mayweather versus Canelo, that's big bucks. That's another 40 million.
Canelo Cotto?
Canelo Cotto, that's big bucks in Madison Square Garden. You know, I would do that in Madison Square Garden on Cinco de Mayo as well if they were going to go that route. But honestly, I don't think Cotto's going to fight much after December. I think Austin Trout is going to give him a really, really
tough time. That's what I'm saying. They're calling me a Cotto hater.
No, Austin Trout is going to put the pressure on him. And there's one thing that Cotto has always had problems with, and it's pressure. You know, in the Mayweather fight, it was easy for him because he was the aggressor. Mayweather really didn't pressure him until later in the fight. With Pacquiao, with Margarito, those guys just kept coming and coming and coming. And that's the exact same thing that Austin Trout's going to do.
Saying Austin Trout stops Cotto?
Saying that Austin Trout stops Cotto. I think he gives him one hell of a fight. And if he gets a draw out of it, it'll be a victory because you know they're not going to give it to Trout over there.
You love boxing. You love boxing since you were a kid. Why do you have an Archie Moore shirt on?
Because Archie Moore is probably the greatest fighter that ever lived, and nobody even knows about
him. But he doesn't get the credit.
Never gets the credit. I'll ask you this. How many fighters do you know that have lost a fight every single way possible? Lost by knockout in the first round to a nobody. Been robbed. Been outclassed by guys they shouldn't be in the ring with to only come back and knock out 10, 15, 20, 25 guys in a row.
Very
and do
few.
It into
the
their
closest
50s.
That comes to mind is Salido, who has 11 losses, but totally different.
You know, and you, Archie, you got to remember, Archie was either 36 or 39 when he won the light heavyweight title and never lost it in the ring. Never lost it. And when he did defend the title, he iced the guys. He iced Johnson, he iced Anthony, and a lot of people don't know this. When he beat Yvonne Durrell the first time, he actually broke the knockout record held by Young Stribling.
That's crazy. There you have it, Archie Moore, a boxing legend. Stay tuned for ESNEWS.com and Money Segback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Segback.